Welcome to Stupid Questions and Stupid Answers, Episode 1. Now, little background on this. People in call centers, nobody ever sees their side. People assume they're a robot, and so sometimes you get the stupidest questions. Or when you're asking really smart questions, you get the absolute stupidest answers. Now for the stupid questions, I am going to answer them with a stupid answer. Just to be a douche. Now I'm going to start with a very common stupid answer. But I will let you know what the question is first. This will be a smart question with a stupid answer, and then I'll give you my thoughts. So, the question is your vehicle a two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, or all-wheel drive? Of people needing roadside assistance. 90% of them say it's a four-wheel drive, no matter what vehicle they're driving. It could be something as simple as a Mini Cooper or something as complicated as a Hummer H3. All branding is property of its own, of their owners. So please keep that in mind. Anyways, they always say four-wheel drive. Their reasoning behind that is the stupid part. It has four wheels. So it must be a four-wheel drive. That is not the case. It is either a two-wheel drive, which is a front or a rear-wheel drive, a four-wheel drive, which is, in 90% of the cases, a 4x4. In other cases, it's just where the wheels run separately, but there's power to all four wheels. And then there's an all-wheel drive, where there's power to all four wheels, but they all run in unison. So, with that being said, if it's a car, a sedan, it's most likely a two-wheel drive, either front or rear. If it is an SUV, it is most likely a four-wheel drive, a 4x4. If it's made by Jeep or GMC, again, brands go to their rightful owners. That is a four-wheel drive in most cases. If it's made before 1994, it is most likely a two-wheel drive. And if it's made by Cadillac, the newer ones tend to be all-wheel drive. Those are for sure. Other ones are kind of up in the air. With that being said, that is the stupid answer portion of this. Now, here's the stupid question. This week, I had a call. I work in a call center. I had a call. Someone just wanting the customer service number. So I gave it. Easy peasy, right? Wrong. What they asked me next made me just want to facepalm for the next 5 minutes. I didn't, though, but it made me want to. They're like, I'm allowed to call this, right? Of course you're allowed to call it. I wouldn't have given you the number if you weren't allowed to call it. Now I'm going to give you the stupid answer. I'm going to give you a sarcastic answer. How some... If I was a moron, I probably would have answered them this way. But I'm a nice guy. I would have probably said something along the lines of, no, I'm just giving you that as your poison apple. Or as you being Adam and Eve and that's the apple in the tree. You really want to ask stupid questions, expect stupid answers. You want to answer something stupidly, expect someone to just want to facepalm. Or want to laugh. Or just want to just shake their head. That is episode 1 of Stupid Questions and Stupid Answers. Please follow me on Twitter at A13ENT. Like and subscribe for more. And I will come up with a new episode with a new question and a new answer soon enough.